Dearest Thomas, these are not words I wish to write. My father has learned of our plans, my love. Yet there is more, far worse, that I wish you to understand, but I fear you may believe me taken with madness. My father seeks to use me, as I have come to believe he used my poor mother. He wishes me to sing for him as she did, to become the star attraction that will draw good folk to this accursed spit of land. My refusal to do so has led to my confinement here at Scare Hotel.
Stop, Scare.
I cannot explain further, but ask that you trust me. I beseech you to compose a melody for me, a counter to the song contained within this locket of my mother's. I realize this request will seem strange, that your first thought will be to come straight here. But without your composition, all hope of holding back the darkness gathering here will be lost. Your love, always, Elizabeth. Thomas! My Thomas! You do not know how wonderful it is to hear your voice. I prayed that you received it, hoped that you would come. I know my request must have seemed strange, and I fear it was all for naught, that everything has changed now. I do not have the words or heart to voice it. It is far too terrible to recount. Please be careful, my love. This place is no longer safe. I'm safe upstairs, but I cannot leave the attic. I've had to lock and bar the door, hide away from the others. My father and uncle, the staff, they have been beguiled by the darkness that inhabits this place. They are no longer themselves, but stalk these halls, attacking anyone that makes a sound. Please, Thomas, listen carefully. Together we can put a stop to all of this. My father made recordings on brass cylinders of a song, a strange melody that affects the mind. If all of the cylinders are played together on the harmonium, this madness will end. You need to find them and bring them to me.
Who are you? Henry! Henry Hughes, you must get me out. Hurry! We must get this door open. Why do you think? They're clearly rogues. They're trying to kidnap me. Please, hurry. Do something. What? No! No, don't leave me! They might return any minute. Oh, do something. I can't break it down from my side. Good. Good. Try again. Harder, man. Throw yourself into it. Wait. No. They're coming. Oh, God, please, no. No, don't do this. Whatever you want, I...
someone else in the attic outside the door, but I think they've gone now. I don't. But you must look to yourself first, Thomas. If you should be caught too... They seem to be drawn to sound. You must remain quiet. Dear God, that's horrific. I dread to think of you being snatched like that too. Our one hope of helping him, helping all of them, is finding the cylinders. But why? What do you think is wrong with them? I knew noise attracted them, but what happened to their faces? Please, take the utmost care. And if I don't answer, it means I've had to hide, that they've come back. Finding the cylinders is our best hope.
beg of you! No!
Thomas! Yes, yes, I'm fine. But I feared the worst had happened. You were gone so long. I dreaded that you'd been taken too. My God! Dear Lord, have mercy! What are they trying to do? That poor, wretched soul. You must be on your guard, Thomas. You can't let them catch you. Oh! That must be Calliope, my late mother's dog. I'd so hoped she was safe. I had good reason to suspect that my uncle had disposed of her. It is so good to hear your voice again. Just to hear your voice again. Oh. But I do not. My father and uncle, my family, had many secrets, and so much is only now becoming clear. The other cylinders must be in the hotel. Perhaps on the first or the second floors. Look for a way to reach me. Some means to come here to the attic. Yes, I'm still here. Well, hopefully you'll be able to find a way up to me now. But please be wary on the first floor. I know that my father and uncle devised all manner of dangers. Watch your step. It's mainly guest rooms on that floor. The library too, and my father's snug. I'm not sure. Perhaps the library. I've not heard anything outside this door for a good while now. But I can still hear them, searching around the other rooms. Take care, my Thomas.
Oh.
to my shame. The truth cuts me to the core. Had I known that my father and uncle had created such vile tortures, such ways to murder... There is an elevator. More of my father's tinkering and engineering. But he made a complex lock, which requires four parts of our family crest to open. Wait, someone's coming. Thomas, you have to hurry for both our sakes. In this madness too. I would believe my grandfather's ramblings insane, but for what my father has intimated of late, if it were not for what I have discovered myself, that our fortune is born from blood, the price we pay for the siren song, the same song you sang, mother, the song father now wishes me to learn. It is utter madness, and yet it holds my father and my uncle, held even you in its thrall. What can I do? What should I do? I cannot give in to my father's demands. Not in good conscience. Not now that I know the truth. That our family legacy is founded on wrecking. Founded on a creature of myth.
Oh!
Thomas? Thomas? My uncle Abraham might be on the second floor now. No, but I heard somebody crashing around a few moments ago from somewhere below me. There is a way up to the attic, through my father's rooms in the west wing. You should be able to reach me that way. My uncle was not a man to be trifled with before. And now, I am not sure he's a man at all. He's a brute, Thomas. I pray you be careful. Please take care, Thomas.
Thank you.
still here. I thought you were... Something just... What was that? What happened? I could hear the sound of... Wait. I thought I heard something here. Somebody is trying the door, Thomas. I must go. No! No, stop! Stop! Let go of me! Let me go! You get off! No!
Thank you.
cover!
That it is impossible, that it cannot be done, at least not in time.
Thomas, can you hear me? You must stay still in the father's mind. Thomas, I told you, only move when he's playing.
Waiting for you by the Grand Tower. Thomas. Thomas! My love! You're safe. I had to flee the attic. I've been hiding from them ever since. But we must hurry. Do you have the cylinders? We shall end all this madness and disharmony and gain control of the siren song for ourselves. Bring order to them. What are you doing? No! Thomas, you don't understand. We must... misery and suffering, to free this thing and my family from this curse. In the light, new harmony was found. Old chains were broken, and in the aftermath of the song's end, a new one began.
In a blend in earth, the mother.